Hello everyone, I am Dr. Munish Kumar Bharadwaj from School of Engineering and Technology of IGNOU. Today, I'll discuss with you transportation and placing of concrete. If you remember, in last lecture, I discussed with you storing of ingredients, then batching of ingredients of concrete, then mixing. So these were discussed in our last lecture. Today, I'll discuss with you transportation of concrete and placing of concrete. These two topics I'll discuss with you. The objectives of this lecture are that after going through this lecture, you should be able to appreciate the importance and precautions to be taken during transportation of concrete, describe the transportation operations, then you should be able to appreciate the importance of placing of concrete, then also you should be able to explain the steps taken for preparation of surface before placing concrete, and you should also be able to discuss different type of vibrators. So let us begin with transportation of concrete. So first of all, what is transportation of concrete? So this is very simple thing, and it is also clear from its name, though just for the sake of definition, you can say that the process of carrying the concrete mix from the place of its mixing to the final position of deposition is called as transportation of concrete. Because you know that the concrete mix is not prepared at the place where it has to be placed or deposited. The mix is prepared at some other place, then it is transported to the place where it has to be placed or deposited. So this process of carrying the concrete mix from the place of its mixing to the final position of the deposition is called transportation of concrete. Let us see what is the importance of transportation. Concrete mix should be transported from its mixing place to the final position of placement in a very short time. This is very important because you know that cement is having its setting time. If you remember initial setting time and final setting time. So concrete has to be mixed and placed within the initial setting time period. Means it should not cross its initial setting time. Otherwise, it will not remain in plastic form and it will not be possible to give the desired shape to the concrete in that case. It will minimize the loss of water by evaporation, because if the transportation time is more, then what will happen, that water which is there in the concrete mix, which is in plastic stage, it slowly evaporates. So if time of transportation is more, means more evaporation will be there and there will be loss of water from the mix. And you know that what is the effect of it, that water which is required for first of all hydration process and as well as from the point of workability, for these two point of view, the water amount of water will be less and hydration will not be proper. First of all, hydration of cement will not be proper, and secondly, the mix will not remain working. So that way it has to be transported within minimum time. Then it will also not allow the concrete to become stiff, because if the concrete is transported quickly, so loss of water will be less due to evaporation and the concrete mix will not become stiff. The mix can be transported either manually or mechanically. So there are the two ways of transportation of concrete. Either you can do manually or mechanically. In case of manual labor, the concrete is transported in iron pans or wheelbarrows are used for transportation. For mechanical transportation, if you talk, pumps or trucks or belt conveyors are used to transport the concrete mechanically. The concrete mix required at lower levels means where the height of the place where the concrete has to be placed is not much. So at lower levels, it is transported by chutes, and at upper levels, means higher levels, it is hoisted by means of barrows lift attached to the scaffold. So that way you can place the concrete at different levels. At lower level, you will use the chutes, and at upper levels or the higher levels, you can use the barrow lift which are attached to the scaffold. Here you see the barrow lift in this graphics. So this lift is there, which is lifting the barrow wheel cart, and this concrete will be placed in the cart, and then it will be lifted to the place where it is required to be placed. Now let us see what are precautions in transportation of concrete, because we have to follow some precautions so that this transportation time is not too much and the properties of concrete are not affected adversely. When water is added to the cement, the process of hydration starts, you know this, and with the passage of time, the cement water paste starts solidifying, thus making the concrete stiffer. Concrete should be transported as quickly as possible to the formwork within the initial setting time of the cement. Means you have to transport and place the concrete in the formwork quickly so that its initial setting time is not over. The process of mixing, transporting, placing and compacting concrete should not take more than 90 minutes in any case. Water should not be lost from the mix during transportation. Concrete mix should be protected from drying in hot weather and from rain during transport from place of mixing to the position of placing. Because if rainwater is going into the concrete, then it will wash out the cement paste from the concrete. The cost of transportation should be as low as possible. Because if you are transporting concrete for a long distance, you have to invest more money on that, and it will add to the cost of your concrete. Segregation of concrete should be prevented under all circumstances. Ready mix concrete in which the segregation is observed should not be placed in any case. Means here, first of all, we have to be very careful about the segregation of concrete, and all efforts should be done to prevent the segregation. If we are using the ready mix concrete and if we see that there is some segregation in the concrete, then that concrete should not be used. The concrete should be kept agitated in truck mixer in order to prevent it from becoming stiff if more time is likely to be spent during transportation. Means if you are transporting the concrete in the truck mixer, then this has to be agitated, means it has to be mixed or rotated continuously so that it doesn't become stiff. The permissible duration of transportation of concrete should be determined in the laboratory. Means we have to calculate the initial setting time for this purpose, and within that initial time only, that whole operation of your transportation placing and compaction that has to be done within that initial setting time. So this initial setting time you can calculate or find in the laboratory. Now let us see what are different methods of transportation. Transport of concrete by pans, transport of concrete by wheelbarrows, transport of concrete by tipping lorries, transport of concrete in containers, transport of concrete by belt conveyors, and finally transport of concrete by pumps. So these are the different methods by which you can transport the concrete from the place of mixing to the place of final deposition or place of use. Let us see first the transport of concrete by pans. It is the simplest one, manual method. Iron pans are used for transportation of concrete. This method is adopted where the quantity of mix is small and access to the point of placing is restricted. Means where the mechanical means or truck mixtures, these are unable to reach that point. So there you can use this manual method that concrete mix can be transported by keeping it in the pans. This method is slow because it is a manual method. So of course this method is slow as well as costly because it takes more labor for transportation of concrete. So that way it becomes costly. Then transport of concrete by wheelbarrows. The capacity of wheelbarrows varies from 70 liter to 80 liters. Steel wheelbarrows with pneumatic tires are used for moderate distances. For example, one type of wheelbarrow you see here in the picture, which is having handles, then container and one wheel. Then let us see transport of concrete by tipping lorries. This method is widely used for the transport of concrete mix and discharging it directly at the position of concreting, such as in the construction of airfield pavements, dams, concrete floors, canal lining and roads, etc. So these are the some examples where we use the tipping lorries for transport of concrete. Tipping lorries are used for transporting ready mix concrete and for arrangements of for receiving loading and reloading it. The height of mix in the lorries should not be less than 40 centimeter in order to avoid segregation. The mix delivered in tipping lorries is discharged directly into the structure that we are going to cast. If it becomes difficult, then the mix is discharged into skips or tubs, which are then moved to the position of placing by crane. Means if we are not able to place directly into the structure, then this mix will be discharged first into the skips or the tubs, and then the concrete will be moved to its final position of placing by cranes. So this is the way how we transport by tipping lorries. Now let us see transport of concrete in containers. This method excludes the loss of mortar and cement slurry during transportation and also ensure the gradual emptying which is necessary for concreting reinforced structures. This is one of the main methods of delivering ready mix concrete from the mixing place to the point of placing without the need for unloading and reloading. This is the advantage. For this purpose, hoopers, skips and wagon bodies are used. Lorries transport hoppers and skips. Containers are delivered from the transport vehicle to the position of placing in the concrete mix by cranes of different types and desired lifting capacity. This method reduces the risk of segregation of concrete and also protects it from atmospheric effects. So these are the advantages of this method. Now let us see transport of concrete by belt conveyors. In this method, the belt used has a covering of rubber of width 60 cm and speed not exceeding 1 meter per second. This is the speed of the conveyor belt. The slump of concrete mix should not be more than 6 cm in any case. The line of conveyors should not have any marked breaks in plan. There should not be breaks in the belt. The angle of inclination of the conveyor must not exceed 18 for 4 cm slump and 15 for 4 to 6 cm slump. So this is the limitation to the inclination of the conveyor. Flat belts are used only for a distance of 20 meters, and if the distance is large, the working part of the belt should be trough shaped. Means for large distances, the shape of the belt should be trough shaped. When the concrete is unloaded from the conveyor or when it is transferred from one part of the conveyor to another, guide boards should be used to prevent segregation of concrete. So in all cases, we have to be very careful that segregation of concrete does not take place. Boards should be arranged properly so as to avoid segregation. Free falling of concrete from the roller of the conveyor is also not allowed. Here in this picture you see the method of discharging concrete from belt. Here you see different methods. On left, a correct method is shown where a guide board is used for placing the concrete from the belt to the place of the concreting. In middle one or the second picture, you see that guide board is used only on the upper part on left side but not on the lower part. It is not used, so it is a wrong method. And also it becomes wrong method if you are not using any guide board. So that way there are chances of segregation of concrete. So this picture tells you about this. This method is used for getting continuous supply of concrete. Because it is being transported by conveyor belt, so the supply is continuous. This method is most suitable under summer conditions for concreting structures at a distance of 250 to 500 meters from the place of mixing, and also in those cases where it is difficult for lorries and other types of transport to reach the structure. Now let us see transport of concrete by pumps. Concrete pumps are used to deliver concrete for concreting densely reinforced structures. Internal structural elements of building and large mass concrete structures. So in such cases, this method is very useful. These are also used for concreting of tunnel linings, because if you have to do the concreting in tunnel linings, then it's a best method is transportation of concrete by pumps. Such pumps cover a horizontal distance of 300 to 400 meters and a vertical distance of 40 to 50 meters. So this much of horizontal distances and vertical distances you can cover for transporting of concrete while you are using pumps for transporting it. Pumping is a process of transporting concrete without unloading and reloading in a vertical or horizontal direction and without a harmful effect on its quality. So that way it is a very good method. In this method, the concrete is charged into the receiving hopper and kept mixed continuously by the pedals in order to retain uniformity of mix and to prevent segregation. The impeller blades through the open suction valve push the concrete into the barrel of the pump. The suction valve closes when the plunger moves to the left. The pressure valve opens, which moves the concrete from barrel into the pipeline. The diameter of the pipeline depends upon the size of aggregate used, but it does not exceed 30 cm in any case. So let us see here in figure 6.2, transportation of concrete by pumps is shown. In the middle part, you see at the top the hopper, which is having pedals. Then below it, impeller blades are there. Then below it is the suction valve, then barrel, and then the concrete pipeline is there. And on right of it is the plunger. When it moves to the left, it forces the concrete to move in the pipeline. So this is the graphics how this pumping of concrete is done. The slump should not be less than 5 cm and not more than 8 cm in this case. The water cement ratio should remain between 0.5 to 0.65. Stiff mixes are not suitable to be delivered by pumps. So this has to be kept in mind because their pumping properties are not good. Stiff mixes cannot be pumped. Sharp turns and bends should be avoided in the pipeline because this poses as obstructions in pumping operation. The number of bends in a pipeline should be as small as possible. And if you can avoid those bends, then it is the best one. Now let us see safety during transportation of concrete. Following safety measures must be observed during transport of concrete. The distance between wagon being moved by hand simultaneously in one direction should not exceed 20 meters in any case and 30 meters on slopes. The distance from the bottom of the skip to the surface on which it is discharged should not exceed 1 meter in any case if concrete is discharged from the skips. Places where lorries are discharged should be equipped with strong supports for tipping lorries. No person should be present on the structure being concreted at the position of discharge of the tipping lorry. The whole system of the pipeline should be checked up by using hydraulic pressure 1.5 times the operating pressure before pumping concrete. Generally, water is used for this purpose, for checking the hydraulic pressure. The driver of the hoist should be able to see the position of charging and discharging the hoist when the mix is to be raised by shaft hoists. The burrow run should be cleaned for the removal of dirt and concrete when concrete is transported by wheelbarrow. If the barrow run is located at a height of more than 1 meter, the boarded surface should not be less than 1.0 meter wide and fencing must be 1 meter high. The thickness of the board for fencing should not be less than 15 centimeter. So these were the some safety measures in our different type of concreting operations. Now let us begin discussion on other topic, that is placement or deposition of concrete. The process of depositing the concrete in its required position is called placement of concrete. It is very essential to place concrete properly and carefully in order to obtain good quality of surface. Areas which will be in contact with the concrete must be prepared carefully before placing the concrete. What is the importance of placing of concrete? The quality of concrete depends on the methods of placing it during concreting. If it is not placed properly, segregation will result. The formation of irregular and unsightly lines will also take place. Therefore, in order to remove the possibility of occurrence of segregation and irregular lines, it is very important to place concrete uniformly and properly. Now let us see what precautions should be taken while placing concrete. The following precautions must be observed during placing of concrete in order to get required strength of the concrete. First of all, the concrete should not be thrown from a height more than 1 meter to prevent segregation. Because if you are throwing the concrete from a height of more than 1 meter, so there are chances of the segregation of concrete. The concrete should be deposited in horizontal layers of uniform thickness, not exceeding 45 cm for mass concrete and 30 cm for reinforced concrete. So, this is the maximum thickness of the layer in one go when we are doing the concrete. No person should be allowed to walk over the freshly laid concrete because it will make mark of the foot. The old surface should be made rough, cleaned and cement grouted before placing any new layer of the concrete so that a proper bond is prepared or made between the old surface and the new concreting surface. The alignment of reinforcement and formwork should not be disturbed in any case when concrete is placed in RCC members, reinforced cement concrete members. Because if there is a disturbance to the alignment of reinforcement and the formwork, then it will totally disturb the purpose of making that structure, because reinforcement is placed according to the design, and if you are disturbing the place of that reinforcing bars, then certainly it will defeat the whole purpose. So that way we have to be very careful. If formworks are disturbed, then its shape will disturb. Shape of the structure will get disturbed. So that way we have to be very careful. Placement of concrete should be discontinued during rainy periods, because if rains is there, then water will be added into our concrete, and if it is raining heavily, then it may wash out our cement paste from the concrete, making it useless. The latents should be removed, means squeezed out, before placing new concrete. Concrete should be laid continuously in order to prevent the formation of irregular and unsightly lines. The internal surfaces of the formwork should be oiled in order to prevent concrete from sticking to the sides of the formwork. The placing of concrete should start widthwise in reinforced cement concrete slabs. Now let us see how we prepare the surfaces before placing the concrete. It is very essential to prepare a proper base or place before placing the concrete mix in order to develop proper bond between the base and the fresh concrete. Before placing the concrete, different types of bases should be prepared, as we will discuss here. First is, in case of hardened concrete base, the coarse aggregate should be exposed by making the base rough. It is made rough by striking sand under high pressure, that is sand blasting. After this, the surface should be washed with water under pressure in order to remove the dust particles from it. After the surface is cleaned, a thin coat of cement paste is applied before placing concrete over the hard surface. Second case we take, in case of specially prepared sub bases. In case of brick soling and water bound macadam, base should be made rough with the help of steel brush. We use the steel brush to make the surface rough. Dust and loose particles should be removed from the sub base before placing the concrete over it. Before placing concrete, water should be sprinkled over the surface. Next is in case of natural soil. So if you are going to do the concreting on natural soil, then what we have to do? Before placing any layer of concrete over natural soil, the soil should be compacted uniformly and its moisture deficiency should be removed initially in order to prevent it from absorbing moisture from beneath the concrete layer. Means the soil should be saturated, otherwise it will absorb moisture from the concrete and there will be a deficiency of water in our concrete that will hinder in the hydration process as well as it will reduce its workability. Next is in case of rocky base. If rocky base is there and we have to do the concreting, then what we have to do? In case of rocky bases, the sides should be cut in vertical direction and not in sloping direction. All the loose particles should be removed off the rocky base before placing the concrete. The water should be sprinkled over the surface to make the saturated surface. So this way we have discussed here what is transportation of concrete, what are different methods of transportation of concrete, then what is placing of concrete, what precautions we should take in the two operations. this all we discussed here. So thank you for watching.